Hi everybody, how you doing? My goodness, I've never seen so many supervisors recognized in one go at a success day ever before. You know, this company is growing so fast and business is all about timing, being in the right place at the right time. And I, for one, just can't tell you how excited we are after 20 years of being in forever to see this incredible growth that we're experiencing here in the UK and actually pretty much all around the world. Prior to forever, my background was in farming, sheep and horses. I used to ride one and breed the other. I had a great way of life. But like so many people in a job, I was working long, long hours, not seeing so much of the children, and my bank account was always empty. Can anybody relate to that? And I had debt, and I was sick and tired of being in debt. So when a friend of ours gave us a call and asked us to come and look at Forever, being open-minded, I couldn't wait to go and meet him. And he was a classy kind of guy. We met at the Torrington services on the M1, and Luton Town were playing at home, so we were surrounded by football fans. And he took out a bit of paper, and he scribbled out the Forever marketing model. And I have to say, being number dyslexic, I just didn't get it at all. But you know, it felt right. There was something about the message that he was sharing with me that just felt right. So we bought our box, which was a challenge for us because at the time we were a bit financially challenged. We bought our box, we took it home, we put it on the kitchen table, we opened the box, we took out the bottle of yellow gel, I poured a massive, huge glass, took a big sip, and that was it. My eyes watered, and I said to John, "What have we done?" John said, "What's the matter?" And he picked up the big glass of aloe and he took a big sip as well. And he said, "This one's gone off." So we rang up Chris and we said, "Chris, you know you said there's a money-back guarantee on the products. Well, sadly, the first product that we've tested, it's gone off. We need our money back." He said, "What do you mean it's gone off?" I said, "Well, it tastes interesting." I said, "It tastes really different." He said, "Jayne, that's the flavor of the aloe." And I looked at John and he looked at me and John said, "And we're gonna build a business with a product that tastes like that?" So at that moment in time, I refused to drink it. And I said to John, "You must drink this product." He knows. So he duly drank the glass of aloe that I pour for him every day. And within about 5 weeks, I had the best night's sleep I've ever had in my entire life. You're probably thinking, how could that be? You're not even drinking it. Because he stopped snoring. And from that moment on, we never looked back. And really, the products are incredible. They've been life-changing for our family. But like so many people, I guess, when you first join Forever Living, this is a new concept. It's a new way of doing business. It's a new way of thinking. It's quite alien to most people. Most of us are used to giving 40 hours of our time, or in my case, maybe 100 hours of my time every week, working in a set routine and getting rewarded accordingly. Whereas in Forever, you can decide what you're worth. Now that's refreshing, isn't it? You decide what you're worth. You decide what you're prepared to work for. You decide what you're prepared to sacrifice for in the early days. You decide what you're prepared to stay up late at night for, get up early in the morning for. It's your choice. And very early on in the early days, we made a choice around 4 children and 2 very, very full-time careers that we were going to be successful in forever. And I think that's one of the best bits of advice I can give you this morning. We didn't join to give it a go. We didn't join to see if it would work. We joined to be successful. How many people in this room joined to be successful? Brilliant. Because all too often our mindset is, we'll give it a go. We'll see if it will work. We'll try. Well, you can't do that. Have you ever tried to breathe? Kind of doesn't work, does it? Have you ever tried to walk? You're either going to walk or you're not. You're either going to breathe or you're not. And in forever, if you want to be successful, you have joined to be successful. Don't play at it. So there we were with a mindset for success, falling in love with the products, massive, massive response to the products within the family. But how do we build a business? you know, we both came from very conventional backgrounds. How do we build a business? Network marketing, case credits, meeting, marketing plan, percentages. It all seemed like a huge amount to take on board. And in the early days when we joined, there was nothing for us to use to begin to create some good habits. There was nothing, no tracks for us to run on. So over the years, the company, and I guess a lot of the leaders in Forever, have put together various planning systems to, if you like, speed up the whole process for each and every one of you that are joining right now in Forever. I'm really delighted to be able to share with you today a very exciting, enhanced, updated, modern, very, very productive new brochure, which is called First Steps to Manager. And this is the next stage of business development. This is the next stage of you being able to sit down with somebody and say, I can show you what you need to do to go from where you are today to becoming a manager. So, what we believe we're bringing to you, we didn't have all this stuff when we joined, you've now got it, and I think that this will allow you to explode your business even quicker than we did in the early days. But what we're bringing to you is something that's fresh, new, and exciting. And it's given you a proven system to run on. We call it tracks to run on. We're giving you something that's very simple to use. One of the things that we love about this new planning manual is that literally, whether you have been in the business a year, 2 years, 3 years, or literally 5 minutes, you can pick up this new manual, you can sit down, and it's logical. It's a step-by-step guide. And as long as you just think a bit about it, anybody can do it. And to me, that means that we speed the process up again. People begin to learn far quicker. It's also important that from day one, when we're building a business, that we create good habits and disciplines and actions with our new people. You know, you must set high expectations. If I'm being really honest with everybody in the room, you have got to put time and effort into this business on a consistent basis. You know, if you've got 15 hours a week, put 25 hours effort into that 15 hours a week. If you've got 10 hours a week, put 20 hours a week effort in. Most people think it to death rather than doing. And this is a doing business, and this manual will help you create the good habits, the good disciplines, and see the importance of achieving the manager position as quickly as possible. And that's what the manual is about. It's about achieving manager very quickly. And it's totally and utterly duplicatable. And again, that's important. The sign of any good business is not just about what you're doing or even what your first generation is doing, but what's happening when your business has gone 8, 9, 10, 12, 15, 20 levels deep. Is the message still strong? Because if it isn't, what will happen is it'll all dilute. And then there are maybe not such good habits being focused on, maybe not such good disciplines being adhered to, and maybe people are a bit sloppy in the way they do business. So we want to give a brand new distributor an amazing start the minute they join Forever by sitting down with them and planning their business. Now, what I will say to you, this is not prescriptive. It is not, you must do this, you must do this, you must do this. It is designed to allow you to focus on the area that's important to you. And I'll just tell you what area that is so you all know what's important to you, and that's getting to manager. Just thought I'd let you know. So there are many, many areas in the manual where you can choose to do things that suit your needs, your personality, and your desires. But what I would suggest is that keep it simple, keep it duplicatable, and share it as quickly as possible with as many people as possible. Now, I can't do a full-blown training on it, so I'm just going to give you an overview of what's in it and maybe how you can begin to link some of the pages up. When we sit down with a brand new distributor, the first thing that we need to do is identify what it is that's important to them. And I can't begin to tell you how important this is. You know, unless someone knows why they're doing this business, they never find out how. And if we teach the how before we've identified the why, then there is no joined up writing. Because people need to have an emotional connection to what they're prepared for work for, and then link that through to the marketing model. So what we do when we first sit down with somebody is we look at the why they've joined Forever in three areas. And those three areas are the personal area. It could be short term, could be in the first 12 to 18 months. Long term is 3 to 5 years. And we literally sit down together and identify the importance of what's relevant in their life. And we just begin to make some notes together. Now, it's really, really important that you help people open their minds. An awful lot of people have never set a goal in their life. In fact, it's a sad fact, a known fact, that most people spend more time planning their annual vacation than they do planning their lives. And if you go out into the street and stop 20 people and say, "Have you got a plan for the rest of your life?" I guarantee you, pretty much 20 people will say no. Why would we leave our destiny in the hands of somebody else? Why would we not take control of what we want our life to look like? So when you're sitting down with a new distributor who may not be familiar with beginning to verbalize what's important to them, to vocalize what's important to them, you may need to help them a bit. Now, when you look at the first pages in the manual, the personal and family goals very often are one and the same. But the one thing I will urge each and every one of you, if you're working with husbands, wives, partners, whatever, is that we're all individuals. And what motivates the wife may not motivate the husband. What motivates one person may not motivate another. So be true to your own personal goals and needs. When we first joined Forever, we were completely broke. I think we had £37 in the bank. And my desire, my deep down burning desire, a desire that was on fire in my stomach, was to educate my kids privately. Now, with £37 in the bank, that's going to be a tall order. Now, John loves the kids. Well, I think he does. But his desire was to have time. Time to be with the family and not stuck in the office from 7 in the morning till 7 at night. So take the time to identify what's important to you, short term and long term. And as I say, your family goals could overlap. But it could be that you want to be debt-free. It could be that you want to make more money, drive a new car. It could be that you've got no pension. It could be that you want to move to a bigger house. It could be that you want to have some money for Christmas. It could be that you want to take the kids on an unbelievable holiday. But you've got to start getting that down on paper, and then you've got to start believing that this will deliver so you can achieve the things that are important to you. For me personally, when I sit down and go through this exercise, what I'm looking for is a range of goals that are important to the individual. But I guess the priority is looking for what they need right now. Because we have two types of goals. We have a need goal and a want goal. And a need goal is what happens right now. I need, by the end of this year, to be making £2,000 a month. Or I need to be able to pay the mortgage, which is £900 a month. Well, I want a Ferrari. Now, here's the thing. Forever will give you a Ferrari, but right now I need to pay the mortgage. So when I'm working with someone, I want to know right now what's the most important thing. And when they tell me, what I then do is I begin to talk about that through the next few pages. And the next few pages go into the marketing model and the simplicity of it. We talk a little bit about the four CCs and how and why we do them, why they're important. And we link CCs to actual products. We've made it a visual. Because for most people, they don't understand what a CC is on day one. But if you take the concept of case credits and you actually link it to a visual of a product, people get it. Seeing is believing. It's so much more powerful. So right up front, we talk about the power of four CCs. And for me, my expectation is, personally, I can't work with people that won't commit to doing at least four CCs. You know, that's my level of expectation. Because when John and I first joined the company and we heard about four CCs a month, I have to tell you, we were pretty freaked out by that. Probably because we didn't really understand it, but we looked at each other and we said, if that's the only requirement this company make of us, to learn how to do four CCs a month and teach it, then we'll do it. On August the 13th of this year, we will have been in Forever Living for 20 years, and we have never missed four CCs in 20 years, never. In fact, already this month, we've done nearly 12 case credits. So your mindset needs to be, you do it, you teach it. And then once you've done that, we quite simply go through a step-by-step-by-step example of going from distributor and the percentages you make right the way through to manager. And what we're aiming to do here is to give a very simple, schematic, visual approach to what a manager business looks like. Because let's face it now, with all the enhancements the company have made recently, with the Eagle Manager incentive, with the Global Rally incentive, with the Global Chairman's Bonus incentive, the business is about developing managers and becoming a manager, developing a manager. So these two pages are all about how to get to manager step by step through the marketing plan. We go on to the next page and we talk about, we now link the goals of the person that we're working with back to that manager schematic. So it's not very clear here, but on the bottom of the screen, you'll see the word manager, and all around that word manager, why manager, are all the key points that most people are prepared to work for. So all I'm doing is linking somebody's why, someone's desire, to the manager opportunity, the manager business, the manager income. Because once you've got to manager and you've got a good structure in place, then you build on that to maximize profit, to take advantage of all the profit centers, and to build real stability into your business. And then straight away, literally straight away at the first planning meeting, we will talk about why senior manager and why they need to find five key people as quickly as possible. Now, a key person is not just someone who's registered. A key person is somebody who has registered and is committed to being a manager. And the joy about this is that if you get five key people in place as quickly as possible, we know within a 4 to 6 month period that not only will you go manager, but you'll have two managers coming up behind you. And this means you can participate in the Global Rally, the Chairman's Bonus, and become an Eagle as well. Now, you know, start talking about these big opportunities the minute you sit with somebody. Unless, of course, they just want to retail the product. Because my experience is in Forever that people join Forever to make money, to drive a nice car, to enjoy global travel, to pick up checks. We're very proud that we can underpin all of that with an unbelievable range of products. But if I'm being honest with you, I didn't join to sell aloe. I joined to build a phenomenal business, to get wealthy, and to use an incredible range of products and make a difference to people with their health. But I didn't join to sell aloe. I joined to build a business. So going on from there, the next thing is to start planning some action. And what we've done here is we've identified all of the different ways that people can begin to retail the product. Because once you've identified the manager position, then clearly we need to start doing some work. And something for us that's very important, literally within 3, 4, 5 days of them joining, is to get a group of people around the kitchen table and to begin to share the products which we underpin with the opportunity. And we call that a product stroke business launch. And the nice thing about this is there's such a wide variety of methods that you can choose to begin to move products out to the end user. So rather than saying you must do just one method of marketing, you choose what you want to do. And we then will work with you to put that in place. But for myself, and I know I speak for maybe, I don't know, maybe half the room here, we really love doing home product launches where we can incorporate product and then a little bit of business. Because from a good product launch, you can retail a lot of product, but boy, you can in the social time at the end of a launch recruit a lot of people. Just out of interest, how many people in this room join Forever as a result of going to a home product launch? If you could put your hands up. Yeah, there's a lot of people that join Forever as a result of a home product launch. One of our top leaders, Chris Goldsborough, joined at a product launch. So don't ever miss out on the fact that you get your products and the opportunity in front of people as quickly as possible. And all we're doing then is quite simply just identifying what area we want to focus on to market our products. So it could be a product stroke business launch, it could be a pup box, it could be weight management, having weight management home demos. Identify what you want to focus on and then quite simply put a couple of dates in the diary as quickly as possible. And that part of the business planning process is done in 5 minutes. And then what follows that is some really nice examples of how you set the product launches up, how you set your weight management evenings up, how you begin to talk to people about the product. Now, going on from there, obviously, it's all about beginning to build a business. So we've got our product commitment in the diary, working towards it. Everybody knows what they're doing. But now, we need to start looking for people to join our business. And what we talk about here is the business building cycle. What we need to do consistently to build a business, and it's really simple. All we do is we talk our new distributor around the cycle, we identify where they live, we identify where their local business presentation is, what night of the week, we talk about the need for a list, we talk about the need to make contact and the various methods of making contact, and then we talk about the need to plan, and it's a very simple process. Once we've done that, what we're looking for very, very quickly is to identify the first people that we're going to start talking to. And in our experience, the quicker that you can work together on this, the quicker you get somebody up and running, literally. If you, at your first planning meeting, do not get them thinking about who they want to talk to and even there and then talking to them, what will happen is they'll put it off and put it off and put it off. 2, 3, 4 weeks go by and they still haven't spoken to anybody because of their internal fears. But my experience is if you sit down with somebody and there and then just say, who do you know? Who would you like to work with? Who's got a great personality? Who's ambitious? Who needs another income? Who do you know that's open-minded, good communicator? And they give you 3 or 4 names. And literally all you do is write those 3, 4, 5 names in the first circles to give them a view of what's possible. And then for me personally, what I do is I literally, in the notes bit at the bottom, I just say, look, with these first 5 people that we recruit, the quicker we recruit them, the quicker we can get you through to manager. And I show them a 5-month plan to manager, and I show them a 6-month plan to manager. Very simple. And then from there on in, we begin to do a couple of profiles, because if I'm going to help somebody make a phone call there and then, or send a text message or an email or a message on Facebook, I want to make sure my message is right and relevant for the prospect. So we do a little bit of profiling, just to find out a bit about that person and how best to approach them. Do you think they prefer a one-on-one with a coffee? Do you think they prefer to have an online DVD? Do you think they prefer to look at the products first? Do you think that they will come through looking at what's going on your Facebook site? It's all of these things. Decide which is the best way and go for it, but go for it quickly. Remember, your expectations were, I joined to be successful, not to give it a go. And so when you join to be successful, your attitude is such, it's speed, it's urgency, it's do it now, not leave it till tomorrow, 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 tomorrow. Now, the homework that we leave people is to do their list. I'm pretty tough on this because personally, I don't know how to build a business unless someone can give me with a list. Now, that list will come from a whole variety of places. It could be what's on their mobile phone, their Facebook page, it's who they have got stored in their head. But one way or another, we need a who do you know list, because if you want to build a big business, you need to be speaking to at least 3 to 5 people a day. Now, what most people do is they speak to 3 to 5 people for the first 2 or 3 days, then they quit because they've had too many no's. Let me tell you one thing. Let me ask a question. Who wants to make a lot of money in forever? Who wants to make a difference in the lives of other people in forever? There's 2 ways to make a difference, with the product and with the income potential. Because most people right now are struggling, and I mean struggling, in the workplace, in the things that they're doing to pay the bills. We have a perfect opportunity here. Never ever let your fears stop you talking to other people. Because if you do that, then you're actually denying somebody the opportunity. So we need to overcome our fears really, really quickly. This is not about phoning 3 people today and having them all say yes. Phone 3 people tomorrow and have them all say yes. Phone 3 people the next day and have them all say yes. This is about a consistent approach to your business. Because I promise you, you'll get more no's than yeses when you first start. I was quite surprised at the fact that my best friend didn't want to join the business. My brother still thinks it's a load of rubbish. when we first joined Forever, he said, no, it's not for me. And I said, well, we're doing it. And he wouldn't use the products. When we started making some money, he said to me, you don't show any signs of making any money. And I said, well, we've got a bit of debt to pay off. When we started making the big money, he said, it will never last. Now we've just agreed not to talk about it. And the sadness is he'd be amazing. But if someone's not ready for the business, they're not ready. But I'll wait, because one day I'll get him. One day. I'm very patient. Because here's the thing. For me, a no is never a no. It's just not today. And if I like somebody, if I believe that person could be good for forever and forever good for them, then I will say to them, I'm sorry it's not for you today. I know the timing might not be right. However, can I keep in touch with you, update you on what's happening? Because one day I'd love to work with you. You've got a great personality. I know that you're ambitious and you'd be a really vital part of our organization. And they always say yes. So a no is never a no. So if the no's are putting you off, learn to handle them effectively and go back to them time and time and time again. But the contact list is really important because what it allows us to begin to do is talk to people about the product, about the opportunity. If someone says no, get a referral, put them on a call forward, and you'll be busy, 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 busy all the time. Doing, not thinking. Inside the manual, there's a brilliant memory jogger. There are fantastic phone scripts. They're all very current. There's messages to use on text. There's ideas for Facebook. There's all sorts of things in there that you can use as a reference guide. And then we get to the activity tracker. And the activity tracker is where we are literally taking a prospect from a thought to paper to contact to tracking. It's very simple. I've thought about this person. I've done a quick profile. I've made contact. Yes, they're interested. Now I need to monitor progress. Don't do things on bits of paper. We did that in the early days. And you lose things and you lose good prospects and you can't remember where you're at with them. So for us, the activity tracker is about monitoring somebody's business so we can see how proactive you are. By the end of your first 60 days, I should be able to look at anybody's activity tracker, prospect monitor, and know exactly where they've mastered the business and where they still need input. And the reality is, if you want to build a big business, you should have 20 current live prospects at any one time in your activity tracker. And then going on from there, really, it's a seven-day plan. The business is about seven-day plans. There's no point putting a plan in for the entire year on day one. In the first 60 to 90 days, the first 3 months, we want to get people really understanding the process that we use to build a business. Once they've understood that, and at the end of their 30 to 60, 90 days, then we can begin to look at the bigger picture. But basically, one of the things that we've learned is most people can function working seven-day chunks of time. So all we do when we're working with a new distributor is sit down with them, put together a seven-day plan, identify all the people we're going to talk to this week, identify any other business they've got to do by way of getting their business card sorted, logging onto Forever Knowledge, logging onto your own group's websites, booking their launches, getting their invites out, and also we want to look at what training events they need to book on, so we put those in the diary as well. Now, sometimes you can do all of this in one planning meeting, and sometimes if people ask a lot of questions, it will take two planning meetings. For me personally, as long as I've got someone catching the vision of going to manager, beginning to use and market the product, and beginning to talk to people and put them in front of me or get them together as a group, then I'm happy. Because over the next few weeks, we can begin to structure it whereby we get them understanding volume mapping, how the case credits come together and what we need to do to actually get to manager on the day that we planned it. So I've raced through this really, really quickly. Pick up your own manual today, have a look at it, become familiar with it. My advice to you is the best way to maximize on this becoming effective in the way that you build a business is to buy these manuals, get together with your team members, get together with your new distributors, get together, do some sizzling, get some group trainings together and become familiar with it, then just go apply, 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 apply. It really is very simple to use, incredibly effective. It gets people seeing the bigger picture very, very early on. It gets people believing they can do it. It gets the duplication process happening. There's a group of us that have been trialing this process for the last few months, and I have to tell you, it's made a big difference to the way people receive, absorb information far quicker, far, far quicker. So in finishing, what I would like to say, if you really want to do something, you'll find a way. And if you don't, you'll find an excuse. Remember what I said, did you join forever to give it a go or to be successful? If you've joined it to be successful, we've developed tracks for you to run on. I suggest you pick it up, you learn it, you apply it, you run with it. Become a manager and create as many managers as you can in the next 2 to 3 years, because I promise you, with this company hitting exponential growth, now is the time to capitalize on the opportunity. Right now. Not at the end of the year, not next year, but right now, capitalize on this opportunity and network as if your life depends on it, because the reality is, it does. Thank you very much, and see you all on the stage as manager or above.
Wow. Is that great? Fantastic document, a fantastic job. Let's have another massive round of applause for Jayne Leach.